Royster. Tonight, we're at Hilliard-Davidson, where we're going to get our first look at the Lancaster Golden Gales tonight, taking on the Wildcats of Hilliard. Let's bring in Tim Shoemaker to talk about those Golden Gales, who started off the season with two losses where they only scored 13 points total. The last two games, they've won, and they've scored a total of 111. What's been going right for them the last couple weeks?
Well, basically, you retool, you make some adjustments, you look at some things. They played two very good teams. Both the first two teams that they played, DeSales and Jerome, are undefeated at this point. But they got the running game going last week and put it on Newark pretty good.
Let's bring in Marion to talk about the host team, the Hilliard-Davidson Wildcats. And Marion, this is a team that, opposite of Lancaster, who lost their first two, won their last two, Davidson has lost two in a row, which doesn't sit well here in this community.
Obviously not, Jared. Both teams 2-2, but took very different paths to get there. Hilliard-Davidson, though, has a lot of strong players coming into this game. They're going to look to run early and run often. They'll be led by their 1-2 punch in the option attack, Ryan Royer and Davis Sinclair. So be looked for them to do a lot of things in the running game, and they're going to want to eliminate some mistakes that they had in the kicking game last week as well. So I look for a good showing out of Hilliard-Davidson.
If you like Smash Mouth football, you're not going to want to go anywhere. This is the game for you. Tonight's pregame show is brought to you by Personal Touch Party Rentals. Carol and Eric Whittington have been serving the community for several years. They invite you to stop by Personal Touch Party Rentals and Events Center in Lancaster. They're a family-owned business. They've been serving Lancaster and Central Ohio area, as well as the Hocking Hills area, since 2003. We would love to plan your next event. Graduation with the Personal Touch, weddings with the Personal Touch, even corporate events with the Personal Touch. Personal Touch Party Rentals can be reached at 740-689-6991. Stay with us. The kickoff is coming up next on the High School Football Game of the Week.
Hi, I'm Dean DeRoff, owner of Kumler Collision and Automotive. You might remember our Kumler Does, Kumler Doesn't commercials, but today I'm simply here to talk to you about our professional team that makes up Kumler Automotive. RASC certified technicians are highly skilled, trained, and dedicated to providing you with the very best in automotive repair, maintenance, and customer service. So Kumler Does offer expert auto service with a smile and will keep your vehicle running like new. And Kumler doesn't mind if you didn't already know that.
The Atom Board is prevention.
The Atom Board works every day to help people recover from substance abuse in Fairfield County.
The Atom Board has been an invaluable partner in our efforts against illegal drugs in our community.
The Atom Board is helping us work towards a better future here in Fairfield County. They're helping us save lives.
The Fairfield County Atom Board is honored and proud to be able to serve thousands of individuals and families in our community.
At Dagger Law, we have more than 110 years of combined expertise in nearly every part of law.
What I think sets us apart from any other law firm is our ability to work together.
With us, you're getting a trusted partner, in addition to a team who can help you with a growing business, changing family, planning your future, or dealing with land issues.
It's a challenge every day, and you meet an awful lot of nice people.
Your case matters. We'll take the time and the energy to ensure that you have a quality experience, quality representation.
Whatever you need, we have a lawyer who can help. Dagger Law. Local. Trusted. Experienced.
Almost everyone needs a car to get from point A to point B, and many families have two or more cars. At Carriage Company, located at 1031 North Memorial Drive in Lancaster, we specialize in hard-to-find used cars. Due to the recent success of the new car market, there is a large inventory of used cars available for resale. We can help you find exactly what you're looking for. With over 15 years at this location and 27 years experience in the business, we are the best place to go to find your next car, truck, van, or SUV. As a member of the Better Business Bureau, we are a Carfax Advantage dealer and offer great financing rates through a local area bank with warranties available on most vehicles. We know your time is valuable, so we take special pride in making sure that you get what you came for at a price that you can afford.
Come into the Carriage Company and check out our sweet deals.
Stop by today and let us help you, or visit us online at carriagecompany.com. Sweet!
IVP Sports presents the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Football Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, Ohio University Lancaster, Fairfield DD, The Huddle Tire Company, Personal Touch Party Rentals, Tiki Bowling Lanes, the Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, North Body Shop, Fairfield Federal, Don's Furniture, Sheridan Funeral Home, Fairfield National Bank, the Edwards Insurance Agency, Kumler Collision and Automotive, the Carriage Company, Adam H., Dagger Law, Infinitely Outdoors, the Lancaster Eagle Gazette, Standing Stone Bank, Buckeye Lake Marina, Tiberio's Restaurante, and Fleet Masters.
And we welcome you back to Hilliard-Davidson High School, where the Golden Gales are set to do battle with the Hilliard-Davidson Wildcats. And Tim, immediately as we talk about these two teams, the keys to the game tonight, for the Golden Gales, it seems like as Noah Dryden goes, this team goes. He's one of the most athletic kids you're going to see on the field tonight.
Well, as a decision maker, and anytime you take every snap and have every play, that person's got to really perform for you, and he does perform. So, you know, I think the real key for Lancaster tonight will make sure that, A, you have good down and distance downs. Both these football teams like to run the football, and two things you can't do is turn it over and have penalties that put you in bad situations.
Our keys to the game brought to you by Buckeye Lake Marina. If you're looking for a new boat, a great pre-owned watercraft, or a place to get parts for your boat, Buckeye Lake Marina has it all. Yes, Buckeye Lake Marina is still open, as well as the rest of the businesses in the Buckeye Lake area, and they look forward to your support. Contact Buckeye Lake Marina at 740-467-2697 or by email tim@buckeyelakemarina.com. It will be the Wildcats of Hilliard-Davidson kicking off to the Gales, and our kickoff coming right up, brought to you by Tiki Bowling Lanes. Fun for the whole family, offering specials throughout the week. To find out more, you can visit them on the web, tikilanes.com. Beautiful night for high school football. Tim, you and I were talking on the way up here. Hard to believe that at 6:30 in the evening, we were driving up here, 87 degrees on week number 5 of the high school football season.
Jared, it's officially autumn today, didn't you know? I mean, from yesterday, it was the first day, and here it is, our first full day of autumn, so... Pretty amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, absolutely. But a nice night here. The field doesn't look to be in the greatest shape here at Hilliard-Davidson, but sometimes you get that. You get middle to late in the season. Kickoff will be taken by Jake Richards back at the 5-yard line. He's up to near the 20, knocked out of bounds at about the 19, and that's where the Gales will go on offense. Lancaster has won 2 in a row. They beat Cathedral out of Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, 2 weeks ago, 55-14. And then they beat Newark last week, 56-21. So they're riding a 2-game win streak. Meanwhile, Hilliard-Davidson, a 2-game losing streak.
But the interesting thing about Davidson, they've given up 28 points last week and 31 the week before. They had not given up more than 24 points since 2012.
Wow. Dryden will hand it off to Shea Goss. Goss coming around to the near side. Of course, Lancaster in that traditional wing tee offense that they run.
Well, you look at it and you see next week, you know, this is just preparation. Next week you start the division play, and it's a gauntlet.
Yeah.
But it's the league you're in, and you know what? You got to get ready. It's a good game to get them ready for that, and they can head off and play Grove City next week, but they got a big chore at hand tonight.
Second and 8, D.J. Pearson lines up right behind Dryden. He'll take the handoff right up the middle, and he's hit hard, but he gets a few on the play. It'll bring up a 3rd down and about 5 on the play.
You know, you said in the pregame, it's kind of an old-fashioned game. We're going to line up. Both teams are going to run the football. Here, Davidson, you said, didn't throw a pass last week.
They didn't throw a pass the first 3 weeks of the season. Last week was their first pass of the season.
And neither team, that's just not a real big part of their arsenal.
Right.
So, you know, Coach White talked in the newspaper about how disciplined you have to be to defense the wing tee defense here.
3rd and 5, Dryden back to pass, looking. Has his man, it's complete, and he's got the 1st down up across the 35. It completed to Tyler Woodruff.
On cue, right?
Exactly.
Not going to throw it. There you go. But that was a nice, simple pass and catch. Nice throw by Noah. And you got to have some of that in there just for some balance.
Let's bring Marion in as soon as we talk about this schedule for Hilliard-Davidson Shoe.
Well, you know, they beat Grove City. Actually, they lost to Grove City. They beat Grove City and Darby and then lost to Bradley and Liberty. And Bradley and Liberty are both undefeated.
Yeah. Here's Brandon Barnett on the carry.
You know, the interesting thing is the two teams that Lancaster's lost to, right off the, out of the gate. They have not lost.
Yeah.
The two teams that Davidson lost to in weeks 3 and 4 have not lost. So, you know, you're not playing chop liver.
Yeah. Marion's down on the field. And Marion, on that pass play that we saw, probably a big key tonight, if they try to pass, is protection. And Noah Dryden did get it in that on that pass.
Yeah, it was nice to see them getting, you know, the first pass of the game completed. And, you know, even though it was short, they were still able to establish a rhythm, get that first down going. But I would be interested to see with Lancaster what they do tonight. There's been a small switch. They've had Goss running fullback the first couple games of the season. They moved him to his natural position of running back of what he played last year. And Pearson is now the fullback. And it's paid dividends these last couple games. And they've, you know, rushed for over 400 yards, I believe, week 3 and 500 yards week 4. So we'll see how that plays out tonight as well.
Very good point, Marion. They did move Shea Goss back to that position where he felt more comfortable, where he ran out of last year.
Yeah, we had talked about that on the way up.
Yeah.
And that's the adjustments you got to make as you progress through a season with your team.
Third down and 4 for the Gales. Barnett in motion. Dryden will keep it himself. He's got running room. First down and more up across midfield. And a nice decision there by the senior quarterback, Noah Dryden.
Well, I know one of the things, even coming into the season, that Coach White from Davidson was worried about, he just felt his team was inexperienced. And, you know, it's much different playing a JV game on a Saturday morning than a varsity game on Friday night. It's just different. And you don't know how they're going to respond.
Yep.
And he had a lot of concern with tonight's game just due to Lancaster's execution up front in the last 2 weeks with their line.
First and 10, Gales right at midfield. Dryden back to pass, looking. Oh, his intended receiver fell down as he was making his cut. He would have been open, but Woodruff, as he tried to make that hard cut, just slipped and fell. Lost his footing.
And now you got two downs here, and, you know, you're right at midfield, so we'll see what they come up with. They've really attacked the, which would be the left side of the Davidson defense, and to the Gales' right, they've really attacked that side of the field so far.
Second and 10. Nick Scott resets to the far side. Here's Barnett. Barnett going over right tackle. Got some running room across the 45 and close to a first down marker. Brandon Barnett has been a nice surprise out of that backfield for these Gales.
Yeah, real nice run right there. A little toughness he showed. He didn't go down easy. And, again, look where they took the offense, to the right side.
Barnett, a 6'1", 185-pound junior. Third down and 3 for the Gales. Dryden under center, sends Barnett in motion. Dryden keeps it himself. He's got the first down and more across the 30 and knocked down inside the 25 at about the 24-yard line. Good run by Noah Dryden. That's twice we've seen him run it on a third down, and twice he's picked up the first.
Well, the thing he's done really well is he's made nice ball fakes.
First and 10 for Lancaster. 8:28 here in the first quarter. Gales so far putting together a nice looking drive to open up. Barnett in motion, takes a handoff. Good blocking by Pearson in front of Barnett. He'll pick up a few on the play.
Yeah, those are nice first down gains. You know, when you get 4 to 5 yards in the way they play, that's really successful game on first down. You know, we've talked for years about, you know, you got to stay away from the procedure penalties, those type of things, the holdings, so that you can have proper down and distance situations. And, you know, you're looking at 2nd and 6 or 7. That's a good down for Lancaster. They've really pounded the right side,
yes,
Jared,
they have.
Hard.
Aikens in motion this time. Fumble on the snap, and Dryden dove past it when he went to fall on it, and it's recovered by the Wildcats.
Yeah, that's a mistake. You just frustrating. Yeah, there was the timing just wasn't real good. Like you said, Jared, I think you called it right. He just overdove it.
So first and 10, Wildcats, after the Gales had a nice-looking drive put together, they turn it over. David St. Clair, the quarterback for the Wildcats. He will hand it off. No, check that. He keeps it himself. And he'll pick up a few on the play.
You know, they were on triple option offense, and, you know, David St. Clair, you already talked about. He has, you know, he's carried the ball over 50 times in the first four games here. So he averages about 13 carries per game. He's got over 280 yards, but the real feature for them is Ryan Royer, who had over almost 1,500 yards last year. He's got 481 yards now.
On second down, here is Sinclair, the quarterback, keeps it himself and has a first down across the 40. Some Davidson fans going a little crazy here in the stands. A little upset at the PA announcer.
Not sure. I mean, we don't hear it here. I mean, we've got our own system here.
He acts like he's coming after us. Here's a handoff right up the middle. Call it a gain of a couple. Kent Hummel on the carry. 5'11", 200-pound senior.
Well, as we said, they're going to run the football. You know, I mean, Coach White's won two state championships.
Yeah.
I even watched one of the state championship games where they never threw a pass. They won a Division I football in Ohio, as good as it is. It just shows if you do your job right and execute within what you've been taught, you can win it doing it anyway.
Sinclair keeps it again. And a good push by the Lancaster defensive line. He picked up a couple, but it's going to bring up a third down and about five.
Yeah, this is big right here. I think for the Gales, they need a good stop here to change and flip the momentum a little bit. You know, I think they felt pretty good that first drive, but you've turned it over and you've let them out of the hole here. It's a big down.
St. Clair with eye formation behind him.
Well, that's almost motion.
Yeah, I thought so too. Keeps it himself, and he's got the first down across midfield. Wow, that first back, the fullback, looked like he was leaning forward.
Yeah, I thought he was in motion, but that's why we're up here not carrying a yellow hanky too, right?
Although it looks like that Coach Albertini out there having a word with the official about it. So first and 10 for Davidson just past midfield. Clock rolls at 5:35 here in this first quarter. St. Clair will hand it off. The second man through, that's his running back, Ryan Royer. And they'll take, you know, 3-4 yards down all day long.
It's the same philosophy offensively by both teams. The big difference is defensively, Davidson's been tremendous over the years. You know, when you go back, this is, what, Coach White's 18th year? 18th season here. He started in 1999. Just had a tremendous program, Jared.
Second down and 7. Handoff. First man through. He's got the first down and more. That is Ryan Royer. You talked about the 17 years they've been doing the same thing. Look at this. They're selling this shirt here at Hilliard-Davidson, and that tells the success they've had.
Yeah, this is Coach White's 18th. So, I mean, it says a lot right there. You got to remember, he's had success with his teams here over that period of time. Almost 80% of the time they've won. That's hard to do, Jared.
Absolutely. First and 10. St. Clair keeps it himself. Wow, what a move he just made. And he's still on his feet inside the 20. Wow, he's going to go all the way. Impressive run for David St. Clair to put the Wildcats on the board first.
He just had a will to score right there. I don't know how else you describe it. He just had a great will to get to the end zone.
Big crowd here on the Hilliard-Davidson side. They like what they saw in that run from their quarterback, David St. Clair. David Hoyle comes on to kick the extra point out of the hold of St. Clair. Good snap, good hold, and the kick is good. And the Wildcats, with 4:28 to play here in this first quarter, take the lead 7-0 after a Lancaster turnover.
Turnovers make it hard to win on Friday or Saturday night anytime in high school, college, professional football. If you turn the ball over, Jared, it's really a simple formula, and that's why people coach defense to force those things because they're such a key element in the result of the football game.
That run happened right down close to where our Marion Royster is standing on the sideline. And Marion looked pretty impressive from up here. What it looked like at field level.
It looked extremely impressive, Jared. He put a shake move on the free safety there. Yeah. And the safeties were really only about 5 or 6 yards off the ball. So he was right in position to make the play. So that play was all David Sinclair, just being an athlete, getting the job done, and really getting this Hilliard-Davidson team off to a great start.
Davidson with this early lead, 7-0, and they will kick it off to the Gales. Back deep is Jake Richards and Keto Akins. The up men for the Gales are Garrett Strang and Tyler Monk. They stand at the 30.
The last time these two played was in 2009 in the first round of the playoffs that year. And Davidson beat the Gales that year, but they also then went on to win the state championship.
That's true. 45-14 was the final of that game. Eight plays, 78 yards, 3:18 off the clock. 34-yard touchdown run for the quarterback, David St. Clair.
Very impressive.
Short kick will be taken by Richards at the 12-yard line. Richards finds a hole up the middle and gets out close to the 30. Said short kick, it looked short, but it had some carry there.
Now here you go, you got to go back to work and they had success, and you know, it predominantly ran to the right, so see what they got in their package here for this second drive.
Good shot into the Gales huddle as Noah Dryden calls out the play and brings them up. They'll start at first and 10 at the 29, trailing 7-0. Barnett in motion. Hand off to Pearson, and he's going nowhere. They'll call it no gain, spot it right back at the 29. Strang will split out wide to the near side. Dryden hands it this time to Shea Goss. Goss across the 30, but not a whole lot more than that.
That defender did a great job of getting off a block that time. I thought they had a gap because it's running right at us here in the booth, and he just broke off his block and broke down and really, really held them to a short gain.
Bring up a third down and about 7 here. And a Davidson player is sitting down at the 37. I don't know if he's cramping up or just stomach problems. Looks like he's holding his stomach. So they'll get him off the field. That's Ethan Royer. So we have an official timeout on the field. Our timeouts tonight brought to you by the Carriage Company, located at 1031 North Memorial Drive. You can check out their website at carriagecompany.com. So third down and 7 for Lancaster, trailing 7-0. Clock rolls at 3:16 to play in this first quarter. Dryden out of the shotgun here. Different look from the Gales. Two receivers to the right, one to the left. Dryden rolls to his right, looking downfield. Fires one down there, has his receiver. It's a first down to Tyler Woodruff.
Nice job. Got inside the hole in the defense and found him, put it right on his numbers. Great job by Noah Dryden.
So the Gales moving the ball.
Well, if they can blend those few pass plays like that and the one we saw earlier into their offense, they're going to be almost impossible to stop.
First and 10, Lancaster. Akins in motion. He'll take the handoff, going around right side. He's got some running room to the 40, and finally dragged out of bounds right about the 35-yard line. Good run by Keto Akins. Gives the Gales another first and 10 here. Strang splits out to the near side. Akins and Goss on the wings. Barnett in the backfield. He takes the handoff, cuts back toward the middle, and picks up two or three on the play. No, check that. That was not Barnett this time. That was Lucas Gowerke,
well,
number 26.
You, it's pretty amazing. If you can, you know, fans can see at home when we have an up view, there's 22 players pretty much within about 15 yards of each other here, Jared.
We were talking to Jim Spires before the game. He said, I'm not going to have to use my angle, am I?
Look here. You know, we're going from the 38 down to about the 25 or so. You get about 15 yards of coverage.
Dryden drops back to pass. He's pressured. And, wow, he got a nice pass in there, but it was not controllable for Garrett Strang. Brings up a third down.
Yeah, he was under duress. He got some pressure from the Hilliard defense.
Third and eight for the Gales. That's one thing, you know, this Gales team is capable of passing the football. Noah Dryden is a very capable quarterback, and they've got some receivers. But when you run those, you got to complete those when it's right to you. Third and eight. It's a reverse. Here's Akins, and almost was upended. Nice balance by him to kind of use his hand to catch himself, and I think he might have gotten enough for a first down.
Yeah, the backs are running hard. It is a first down. I see the official waving them on.
He was hit right around the line of scrimmage and was able to catch himself and keep on going.
They marked it short.
Wow, they did, didn't they?
I saw the one side judge here.
The referee
waving
even
it
was
on.
Waving, wasn't he?
Really? I was watching the side judges. They're going to come out and measure? If you look at this marker here, Jared, it's at about the 41 and a half or whatever, and they mark the ball at the 41, don't they?
Yeah.
I know we're quite a bit away.
Looks like it's about the 26.
Yeah, we got some distance to us here from our view, but here they come. What do you think?
I'm going to say first down.
I thought from the initial viewpoint here it was.
And it is. So first down, Gales. Good run by Keto Akins.
It's at home field advantage trying to work over there is what
true.
That is, yeah. Same area of the field they were last time.
That's true. Minute 28 to play in the first quarter. Dryden keeps it himself. Follows Akins. And he's got a gain of about three or four on the play.
What I liked is how hard he faked that ball in his belly. He did a great job of sticking it in there. And it's very, very, very important to this offense that he used deception.
Second down and six for the Gales. Gowerke lines up right behind Dryden, giving Brandon Barnett a break. Gowerke just a sophomore. He's been getting some quality playing time and doing well out of that backfield. Here's a handoff to Goss coming around the near side. One of the few times they've come this way, and he cuts back to the middle and picks up a few.
Yeah, made a good initial cut to make the first defender miss, but nice tackle by the Hilliard defender right there.
Clock rolls down inside of 1 minute to play in this first quarter. Third down and three for Lancaster. Parker resets to the left side. It's a handoff. No, Dryden keeps it himself. Dives forward as he's hit at the 15. He has the first down.
Tell you what, there's two quarterbacks on this field who got great will tonight.
Yes, they do.
And I love it. It's fun to watch.
And that's probably going to be the last play of the first quarter. They're going to let the time run out, switch ends of the field. Well, the Gales are moving the football at will. They just had a turnover there that bit them in the butt in the first part of the game.
And give Hilliard's offense, you know, credit. They made the plays, and you know they're a two-headed monster, you know, with Royer and St. Clair, and they really featured St. Clair that first drive.
Should we have some sponsors we'd like to thank tonight?
Let's say thanks to Fairfield Medical Center, improving quality of life through patient care and education. Fairfield Medical Center is people you know and care you trust. And also to Ohio University Lancaster Pickerington. With over 250 Ohio University majors to choose from, you can receive a high-quality education taught by faculty that care about your success and at half the price of most other schools. Apply today at ohio.edu/Lancaster and earn a degree in exciting career you've always wanted. And finally, your community newspaper, the Lancaster Eagle Gazette, gives you news, weather, sports, and so much more at LancasterEagleGazette.com. For up-to-date game stats, look for them on Twitter at #EagleGazette.
I want to thank our crew tonight. Our field reporter, of course, Marion Royster. Our top camera following all the action is Jim Spires. Side camera up in the right behind the student section, I believe, is Kirby Wolliver. Down on the field is Tom Russo. And in our production truck tonight, Aaron Uhl, Bob Campetti, Jason Roush, and Beth Campetti. First and 10, Gales. Goss will take the handoff. Cuts back to the middle, spin move at the five, and into the end zone.
Wow.
Touchdown.
What a great run, and I tell you, the line did a great job, Jared. There was a huge opening for him to get through. He just had to do the rest to get to the house.
Great run by Shea Goss to put the Gales on the board. We'll see if they can tie it up here with this extra point coming from the foot of Justin Harris.
He certainly looks comfortable playing the wingback position
there,
doesn't he?
It'll be out of the hold of Jaden Jones. Low snap. Kick is up, and it is good. And we are tied up with 11:54 to play in the first half, tied up at 7. And let's go down to Marion. Marion, you know, a lot could be said about the wing tee offense not being, you know, not being entertaining to watch from a fan perspective, but when it's run well, it can really work for some teams. And of course, you being a former running back, it's probably an offense that you would love to run, wouldn't it be?
Well, it's funny that you say that, Jared. It's actually almost identical to the offense that we ran at Ohio University my first couple years there. Just a lot of misdirection, keeping it on the ground, you know, running inside, outside, really tiring out those linebackers, making them chase running backs all over the field. And it forces the defense to have to stay disciplined, because that one time you miss your assignment, you miss your dive, or you miss the counter, you miss the running back coming through, he's gone up the sideline. So, you know, if Lancaster continues to execute outside of that botched snap, they've really executed to perfection tonight. So as long as they continue to do that, they should be in really good shape.
Of course, we mentioned that Marion played at Ohio University, and he led the way for a guy by the name of Calvin McCray, who's on the coaching staff of Hilliard-Davidson. He coaches their running backs, and I believe Calvin McCray is the all-time leading rusher at Ohio University. But we'll give Marion credit for leading the way for that. After this kickoff, we'll tell you about the drive summary. Goes out of bounds.
Yeah, it's not what you want to do.
11 plays, 71 yards, 4:29 off the clock. A 13-yard touchdown run for Shea Goss to get the Gales on the board and tie this game up.
And interesting, that touchdown came off of the left front side of the Lancaster offense.
Free
they
kick
pounded
out of
the right
on
for
the
quarter,
team.
Whole first quarter, and then they scored running to the left.
First and 10 for Hilliard-Davidson. Sinclair under center with Royal right behind him. Two receivers to this near side. So a lot of the David Sinclair show there. First offensive possession. He'll keep it again. Coming near side. Lots of running room. Great job by David Sinclair getting up to midfield.
Yeah, the Gales are going to have to make sure they account for him. Right now, he's kind of getting loose too easily. As I said, they're a two-headed monster for the most part. When you look at their offense and the total yards gained, it's Royer and St. Clair, so you really, really got to find some way to really curtail them.
First and 10 at the 49 of Lancaster. St. Clair will give it to Royer. Again, a huge hole there opened up by that offensive line, right up the middle.
Yeah, you'd kind of call that, if you're coaching, that's a gash. They kind of gashed you right there. They opened that right up. Hilliard's front line did a fantastic job of giving him space, and boy, did he come through it hard. See, they're showing I formation. They run a lot of option stuff.
Here's Royer again. This time he just lowers his shoulder and runs over top of a couple of Lancaster defenders and give him about three on the play.
Yeah, the fullback in Hilliard's offense, for the most part, is like another lineman, Jared, except he's on the move. He's coming out of that spot looking for a linebacker to put his hat on somebody to create a better space for the tailback.
That fullback you talk about is Kent Hummel. He's a 200-pounder, 5'11". Here's Royer. He's got a first down across the 30.
Yeah, that time they just went split backs right there, and it's a quick straight handoff right up the line, and we had it right in front of us, and Davidson line just really blew off the football.
Even though Davidson runs the ball almost 100% of the time, it's still an up-tempo, seems like an up-tempo offense.
Absolutely. Coach White is very, very, very big on creating tempo with his offense.
High formation once again. St. Clair to Royer, and he's across the 25.
Now, even if you're just a casual fan and you want to watch, watch what they do. They take the slot back. When they go to hand off to Royer, they'll take the slot back from the right. He'll come in and lead block. The fullback will follow him, and then Royer gets the football. So they're using a lot of schemes in action here to get blocks on people to get them into the second level.
Second and six. St. Clair keeps it himself, and he's going to be wrestled down at the 20, but he's very close to another first down.
Yeah, a little better job right there by Lancaster. This time they did not go to the formation strong side. They came back, and they're going to run the option. Yeah. And you got to remember, when they run the option, there's a high percentage of time that St. Clair's going to keep the football. So you got to really be conscious of that defensively.
They give him the first down, first and 10 inside the 20. Spotted at the 19, 9:35 and running here in the second quarter. Here's Royer again. Big hole, Royer inside the five, touchdown Davidson.
Yeah, right there was an example of what we just talked about, the blocking. We go back and watch that. You watch the two lead blockers in front of Royer when we re-show that touchdown. He's a good runner, that's for darn sure. Yeah. You don't gain almost 1,500 yards without being one, but watch the blocking that he gets on this play.
On to kick the extra point is David Hoyle. Good snap. And the kick is good. Hoyle boots it through. So with 9:23 to play in the first half.
See right there.
Wildcats take a 14-7 lead. You're right.
Prime example. The wing came in and led. The fullback followed him, and they got their hats on somebody in the second level, moved him out of the way, and Royer did the rest.
Scoreboard sponsor tonight is Buffalo Wild Wings. Thanks to Larry Tipton and the gang for great food, great service, and the best sports viewing in town. It's all at Buffalo Wild Wings in the Plaza Shopping Center on North Memorial Drive. And remember, for every one of our games of the week, Buffalo Wild Wings will have their instant replay televised after the game at the Buffalo Wild Wings Lancaster location. So far, it looks like a matter of who's going to stop who first.
Yeah, the turnover is the only difference in the game, really, right now. No one has really stopped anyone. And, you know, like we talked about, Davidson, you know, they're always really sound defensive. You don't win championships without having a really sound, good defense. But, boy, they've got their bell rung the last 2 weeks.
Akins and Richard are the deep men. Strang and Monk stand about the 30. Seven plays, 65 yards, 2:31 off the clock, and a 19-yard touchdown run for Mr. Hoyer.
They made it look easy,
Jared. Royer, that is. Here's Akins. Cuts back to the middle, across the 20, and he'll be brought down right about the 22, and that's where Lancaster will go on offense. So first and 10, Lancaster. Beth Compatti is going to have her work cut out for tallying up all the rushing yards tonight.
Well, the bottom line is there's not much break in between because the clock keeps running, too.
That's true. Dryden has Pearson right behind him. Barnett in motion. Here's Pearson right up the middle. And he'll gain 3 or 4 on the play.
Yeah, nice run right there. Fake the pitch out and gave it back to the fullback, and that's a nice gain to start your offense. Gain 4 yards, you'll take it.
That's one thing we've seen Lancaster do really well over the years is they have a stable of about 7 running backs, and so they're able to give 2 or 3 guys at a time a rest for a series and then bring them back in the next series ready to go.
And they've been very blessed. They've had some really good players in the backfield.
Here's Akins. Or is that Goss right up the middle? Short gain. It'll bring up a 3rd and short. 3rd and about 4.
And then press box says 3, but it's in between. 3.2 maybe.
Wildcat fans trying to come to life and get their team to get a stop here. It would be big if they could. Pearson is right behind Dryden. We've seen him run on 3rd down twice tonight and convert. Here he does it again and not going to make it this time.
And again, they did what we talked about earlier with Lancaster. You kind of got to take something away. So they made a commitment right there to really focus on Dryden. He'd been faking the ball really well, getting loose on the perimeter. They did a great job defensively to make sure that Lancaster's going to have to give the football back to him.
Lost a couple of yards there, so the Gales will be forced to punt. Noah Dryden does do the punting. Back for Hillier-Davidson is Jesse Wymard. Dryden, an end-over-end kick, but kind of a line drive. Very returnable for Wymar. But he's doing
good
some
job.
Spinning. Boy, Lancaster really converged and didn't allow him to go anywhere.
Now, once you start tiptoeing, you're in trouble because help's coming.
Well, if you ever need a stop and you're Lancaster, this is when you need it. Can't afford to go down 2 touchdowns.
Well, you know, the first quarter we saw a lot of David St. Clair. Second quarter, Royer just really, they got him going, Jared. They really just did a nice job of blocking up front, and he is very talented.
1st and 10 for the Wildcats. Royer in motion. St. Clair, boy, what a move. Just those stutter steps right there at the line of scrimmage. He's able to go forward for about 5 more yards.
Now they run that option, you know, and he knows what to read. But like I told you earlier, you always got to count on him keeping the football. If somebody else beats you, you got to make somebody else beat you. And I think, like I said, defensively, you got to come in with, you know, a focus of controlling. You don't necessarily shut people down, but you got to control St. Clair and Royer.
That was an 8-yard gain on 1st down, so make it 2nd and 2. Clock inside of 7 minutes to play in the first half. Gales trail it 14-7. St. Clair keeps it over the right side this time and has the 1st down.
What I tell you, he's not going to give it up probably.
That wasn't him. 1st and 10. 45-yard line is where the Wildcats have it. St. Clair sends his man in motion. He'll give it to Royer, and this time a nice job by the Lancaster defense. Hey, let's go down on the sideline. Marion Royster standing by with some special guests.
I'm here with some special guests for sure, Jared. The rowdiest bunch you want to find. That's the Hillier-Davidson Paw Pound. We got the leaders of the Paw Pound here. I'm going to let them introduce themselves.
My name is Sammy.
I'm Connor.
I'm Travis.
Derek.
Matthew.
All right, and all you guys are seniors, correct?
Yeah.
All right, so somebody tell me, how did all of this get started?
It's just a huge tradition to hand down the Cats letters from senior to senior each year.
Okay, so it's a special, each person has a letter that's specifically designed, that's designated for you, right? Wow. That's great. So this is going to continue long after you guys are on and graduated, right? That's great. Now, here's the real question. When it's not 75 degrees and it's about 15 degrees. Are you guys still going to be out here with the letters and painted chest?
Honestly, hey, I'll be honest. I don't know. That's kind of hard. It'll be cold out here.
All right, great. Well, I know you guys are seniors. Got any plans after, you know, high school and what you're going to be doing when you're not, you know, painting up and putting letters on your chest?
Probably just be teeing up.
College. Furthering my education.
College somewhere.
I'm going to apply to Ohio State.
All right. Well, we wish you guys the best of luck and go Wildcats, all right?
Yeah,
how about that? Even the student section gets things handed down to them. I tell you what, they've got a huge student section to our right. It spans from the, looks like the front row all the way to the back of this stadium.
My question is, when they come back as alumni to a game, do they have to wear their letter?
Good question. Yeah. Well, the action on the field as that interview was taking place was we had a good stop by Lancaster and then a nice run by St. Clair to give him a first down. Here's Royer. And Royer, wow, how did he stay on his feet there? Down to the 10-yard line. Boy, with Royer and St. Clair, Gales have their hands full.
You know, I'm sure you can think of, you know, tandems in the past. I'll make myself feel old, but way back in the day, Tennessee had a combination of Bernard King and Ernie Grenfell. They called it the Bernie and Ernie Show. This is the Royer-St. Clair Show.
That's
tonight
true.
Right now.
First and goal, ball spotted just inside the 10. Clock down to 4:14 and counting here in this first half. Keep in mind, Davidson will get the ball to start the second half. Here's Royer, and he stopped. Here's the mascot. Did he eat the camera? Wow.
It's awful dark in there. Don't let your kids watch, Jared. Don't let them watch.
True. Second and goal. Ball spotted at the 6-yard line. Davidson already leads 14-7. St. Clair keeps it and dragging a man with him. He's down near the 1-yard line.
The thing that's also impressive with Davidson is not just their execution, but I guess you could put this in there, but they haven't turned the ball over. And Jared, how many times have you seen the penalty flag thrown?
That's true.
You know, that just makes you play
one,
a clean
right,
game.
On the kickoff.
Exactly.
And that was on Lancaster, so clean game. Third and goal. Looks like the ball spotted at the 2. Here's Royer, and he is in for the touchdown.
He scored 20 times last year, so he's used to getting beyond the line there.
Well, you know, they don't have a, wow. I don't know if you get a shot of that, but that Wildcat mascot just did several backflips down the track.
That's a gymnastic
I'd say.
Wildcat, I'll tell you. Be careful, Marion. Be careful.
No, what I was saying, though, this is a Wildcat team. Remember, they've lost 2 in a row, which is kind of rare for them. They're not very happy coming into tonight's game.
No, one thing Coach White can do is get you focused. He does not mince words.
Extra point is up, and it is good. And with 2:55 left to play in the first half, Wildcats take a 14-point lead, 21-7.
And the thing about it, Jared, it's not about winning and losing games. When you are asking players to do specific things, you're not just trying to help them as players, you're trying to help them as people.
Yeah.
And what you have is an expectation of physical and mental effort. And obviously, I think physically he felt they were trying and doing things right, but mentally he was very disappointed. And we read the article from This Week News, and he was very disappointed in that end of it. So I think he's had a week of getting things straightened out because they look really sharp
tonight.
Yes,
they do. 8 plays, 70 yards, 4:19 off the clock. 2-yard touchdown run for Ryan Royer. Well, the Gales have to have something right here. Trail it by 2 touchdowns, and they will give the ball to Hilliard Davidson to start the second half.
Well, they've never stopped him.
No.
You know, they haven't been able to stop them yet. So, puts a lot of pressure on your offense.
Kick will be taken at the 5 by Akins. Akins out to about the 22 or 23-yard line.
You know, and when you look for things to come, we know what Lancaster's division's like with both Pickerington schools, Reynoldsburg, Gahanna. Now Hilliard's still got up Arlington and Dublin Kaufman, both very, very good teams, well coached and very successful every year. So these teams are looking to get better at this point in the year.
And we have a whistle and an official timeout as the clock was still running. Thought maybe they'd try to put more time on it. The clock was ticking down. Should be about 2:47 according to our production truck.
They put it to 2:30. It was what, 2:11 there?
Yeah, it ran down quite a bit. Still don't think they put enough on it. We'll go with Jason's clock. He had 2:47 in the truck.
I would say he's probably more accurate.
First and 10, Gales. Shea Goss, not much running room there. Well, after Lancaster kind of ran all over top of them the first two drives, even though they fumbled in the first one, these last two, they've had some struggle.
I said Coach White is really a great defensive coach. If you look over the years, and you can go on and look at each year. Davidson has a wonderful website that has excellent. Yeah. But you can look at each year, and you look at week in, week out scores. Defensively, they're usually almost always sound.
Dryden will roll to pass to his left, firing downfield, and wow, what a, oh, I thought he had it.
Yep.
Just lost it as he hit the ground, but a nice effort by Tyler Woodruff. He laid out.
He may have landed injured.
I think he did land on the football, which will always take the wind out of you. But wow, what an effort.
Yeah, it's like stepping on a balloon when that happens, but yeah, that's tough.
Watch this replay.
Well, watch the effort. I mean, that's a nice throw. Just a tad far, but you know what? That's a great effort.
Yep. Replays tonight are brought to you by Kumler Collision and Automotive Repair. Thanks to Kumler. They've been with us for quite a long time.
I can't remember when they weren't. That's what I tell people. Yeah. How long is it, when they ask me how long it's been, I said, you know, it's been so long, I can't remember when it wasn't. So,
a great effort by Tyler Woodruff. Pass was just a bit overthrown. Would have been a huge gain for Lancaster.
Yeah, but I like that vertical play for their offense. You know, down the road, you know, they got to make some of those type plays. And, you know, you can feature the run and execute. But, boy, if you can add a little bit of that in, they're going to be a tough handle. But this is a good game for them to come up here and find out where they stand. These are two teams in the same region. Lancaster is slightly ahead of Davidson at this point. So, you know, you're playing Davidson probably at maybe the worst time, I would say, Jared, you know, coming off losses.
That's true. You almost
want to come in when you think maybe they're a little overconfident because Coach White talked about their confidence level was down a little bit. And like I said, he has just a really good way of getting people refocused.
Well, good to see Tyler Woodruff making his way off the field. Coach Carpenter had made his way out. Lancaster training staff led by Lee Spring, as well as the Davidson training staff, were out there checking on him, but he looks to be okay. And the Gales will face a third down and 9. Clock stopped at a minute 50.
There's that shotgun look again, Jared.
Three receivers to the left, one to the right. Dryden again, rolls to his left, keeps it, cuts back to the middle, and that last cut.
Oh, boy.
Did not go very far, and there was a late jump on right there, but no flag.
Sure was.
Fourth down and 2, and the Gales will be forced to punt. Boy, it looked like he was going to be able to get that first down, but that last cut, boy, defense just converged on him.
Well, both teams, especially on defense, talk about, you know, the fundamental tackling, and right there you saw a great example of that with the Hilliard players.
Dryden will punt, back to punt. And back to receive it is Jesse Weimard. And looks like Lancaster will call a timeout. Like Noah came out of the huddle there almost confused as to what he might be wanting to do. Did you see that too, Marion?
Yeah, actually I did. Not exactly sure. They may be talking over exactly what they end up doing. But, you know, one thing I was going to comment on, Lancaster taking a shot there. They took a shot on second down down the field for Woodruff. So when they don't hit that, that gives them a third and long, which unfortunately takes them off of their normal kind of progression. They're used to third and shorts getting 3-4 yards of play. So it kind of messes up the drive. So it's kind of big risk, big reward if they get it. But unfortunately, if they don't, then, you know, they're off schedule, and then it gets them to a point where they usually have to punt.
Good point.
Well, I think they felt on the last drive a little bit. You know, we saw the third down play that Davidson was kind of ready and had, you know, over-pursued him, and they thought might catch him off guard. And as Marion said, it's a big risk.
Yeah.
But at some point, especially if you have a fear that you can't stop the other team, and right now, if I were coaching defense, I'd feel a little insecure.
Yeah.
You got to figure out a way to try to get some points.
Yep. Surely they were not talking about possibly a fake punt here.
No way at that point.
Kind of a running kick to the right. Weimart will take it at the 31. He apparently called for a fair catch pretty early.
He had been instructed.
That was a quick.
Yeah, that wasn't his decision.
Yeah.
That was an instruction, Jared.
So Hilliard Davidson with some time here. 58 seconds on the clock, and as they run that up-tempo offense, even though it's a run, I think they still have all their timeouts, don't they?
They do.
St. Clair will be under center. He's got his fullback right behind him. That's Kent Hummel. Hummel takes a handoff. He's across the 35. And will Davidson call timeout? They will not.
No, I think he's going to see what happens maybe on this next play or so.
Second and 4. St. Clair gives it to Royer. And he has a first down up to about the 43-yard line.
He's not only got some speed and moves there, he's tough.
He is.
He's a tough cookie. You can see right there as he banged into the defenders and fought for and leaned for a little more yardage. That shows his toughness right there.
So now Hilliard Davidson will take a timeout. I believe. I didn't see anybody make a signal, but both teams are going to the sideline, so I'm assuming it's a timeout.
Must be.
Hey, I want to tell you, coming up, you don't want to miss our halftime show. Our halftime band show is coming up. It'll be brought to you by Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, Crematory and Monuments, family-owned and operated since 1889. Their website at funeralhome.com will guide you through the choice of dignified funeral services and monuments with personalized options. Respect for tradition, regard for change. Halftime band show also brought to you by Fairfield Federal. Fairfield Federal Savings and Loan makes it easy to take control of your personal finances and build your wealth. You can access and manage your accounts 24 hours a day with our internet banking and bill pay service. Fairfield Federal Savings and Loan specializes in banking that revolves around you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Stay tuned. That band show coming up shortly in just under a minute. We want to congratulate the Lancaster Band of Gold as they qualified for state band competition. Last week at their own show that they hosted at Fulton Field. So congratulations to them on their superior rating. First and 10, Hilliard Davidson. St. Clair keeps it himself. Now he pitches it a late pitch to Royer. Royer up across the 40, 35, 30, and finally brought down near the 25-yard line.
See what's so smart about that? You got your two best players involved with the football,
yep.
Jared. That's just such great coaching.
Did he get out of bounds over there? Will they run this clock when they spot the ball? He must not have gotten out of bounds, because they're going to call a timeout here. And Shue, just watching their extra points, their three extra points that they've kicked, they've got a kicker. David Hoyles has a leg on him.
Yeah, the story of David is he was a soccer player again. And years ago when Davidson was making those runs into the state tournament, you know, not that long ago,
yeah.
But if you remember, they had a kicker that was an absolute weapon. He put everything out of the end zone. He could punt. And boy, could he kick. And I'm not sure, he went to a Division I school, but they always seem to have a kicker because Coach White has a definite concept of his program.
Yeah.
Okay, they're going to run the football, be clean, not make penalties with turnovers. They're going to play really sound defense, and then they're going to play field position with kicking game. And if you can get that, that's fabulous. Yeah. And, you know, you're in a district big enough. But the people, what's interesting to see is we see all the people here in the stands, everything. Nobody's discontented
or
whatever.
True.
No, they've bought in because it doesn't matter what system you run. If you teach it well and you get your players to understand it and they buy in, it'll work.
And my guess is it's this big of a crowd on the road as well when they go on the road.
So.
It's a huge crowd on this near side. St. Clair keeps it himself. It was the same option play, only to the left side, and finally brought down near the 20-yard line as the clock goes down to 11 seconds.
You see how well he protect the football, though?
Clock down to 7, 6.
Have to call timeout.
And he's going to call a timeout here under 5 seconds. And they're going to bring their kicker, David Hoyle, on to try to kick a field goal here. But, Tim, we talk about this crowd. It is absolutely packed on this near side. You've got what must be the junior high cheering section.
Yep.
Down to our left. Look at this shot. And on our right, down to our right, is the high school cheering section, student section. Look at that.
Fabulous.
Barely an empty seat in this place.
Yeah, that's fabulous.
So just a nice crowd for really good, supporting a really good high school football team here. And that's where we are, right under the Wildcats. And David Hoyle will come on to kick a field goal. It'll be spotted down at the 27-yard line. So make it a 37-yard attempt out of the hold of David St. Clair. Kick is up, it's on its way, has the distance, and it is good. So as time runs out, Harrier Davidson puts three more points on the board as David Hoyle kicks a 37-yard field goal, and the Wildcats lead at 24-7 at halftime.
Great second quarter by the Wildcats, Jared. Flawless, actually.
It is halftime. Our halftime tonight brought to you by North Body Shop, providing quality customer service, parts, and reliability since 1979. Owner Mark North will provide you with a free written warranty on each estimate. That's Mark North of North Body Shop. He'll treat you right. Stay tuned. The Halftime Band Show coming up next on the High School Football Game of the Week.
IVP Sports presents the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Football Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, Ohio University Lancaster, Fairfield DD, The Huddle Tire Company, Personal Touch Party Rentals, Tiki Bowling Lanes, The Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, North Body Shop, Fairfield Federal, Don's Furniture, Sheridan Funeral Home, Fairfield National Bank, the Edwards Insurance Agency, Kumler Collision and Automotive, the Carriage Company, Adam H., Dagger Law, Infinitely Outdoors, the Lancaster Eagle Gazette, Standing Stone Bank, Buckeye Lake Marina, Tiberio's Restaurante, and Fleet Masters. Come experience the Huddle Tire difference. Locally owned and operated since 1910, we're your independent tire and auto repair shop. We carry all major brands of tires, including Goodyear, Cooper, BF Goodrich, and many more. But we're more than just tires. From safety inspections to alignments, brakes, shocks, and struts, even preventive maintenance, we can handle it all. Enjoy the ride at Huddle Tire Company, 300 South Columbus Street, or we can be reached at our website at huddletire.com.
Baseball scores. to be in the building for the long tradition of success in the state of Ohio, including participation in the
My name's John Hamilton. I'm 21, and I live in Lancaster. I look at the account, the dog shelter. Well, in the morning, we had a meeting, and then they tell you what to do. I open all windows up. I get the boys disinfected. I give dogs water. I pick up trash outside sometimes in the parking lot. Basically, I pour the water bowls out, and I fill up the water bowl, fill it up. Then I put it back in there sometimes. Do that, get dogs water. All the co-workers are nice back here. They're all nice. Well, people need to give dogs a chance because dogs, you give dogs a chance, a dog will be your best friend. And dogs won't be so mean if you don't go hitting on them, but if you be nice to a dog, they'll be nice back to you. Got a black and white dog, puppy here, and I bonded with it and it got adopted out, so. I miss that dog. It's a cool dog. My dad, he like shows me how to do stuff. It's like I'm outside mowing the grass. I didn't know how to mow the grass. So my dad showed me how to mow the grass. It feels good to help my dad pay the bills in the house. So it feels good to have a job to help my dad with the bills. You can get a job, just do a good job. When your boss tells you to do something, you just go out and do it and prove to your boss that you can do it. I like to work here for a long time.
Almost everyone needs a car to get from point A to point B, and many families have two or more cars. At Carriage Company, located at 1031 North Memorial Drive in Lancaster, we specialize in hard-to-find used cars. Due to the recent success of the new car market, there is a large inventory of used cars available for resale. We can help you find exactly what you're looking for. With over 15 years at this location and 27 years experience in the business, we are the best place to go to find your next car, truck, van, or SUV. As a member of the Better Business Bureau, we are a Carfax Advantage dealer and offer great financing rates through a local area bank with warranties available on most vehicles. We know your time is valuable, so we take special pride in making sure that you get what you came for at a price that you can afford.
Come into the Carriage Company and check out our sweet deals.
Stop by today and let us help you or visit us online at carriagecompany.com.
Sweet!
At Dagger Law, we have more than 110 years of combined expertise in nearly every part of law.
What I think sets us apart from any other law firm is our ability to work together.
With us, you're getting a trusted partner, in addition to a team who can help you with a growing business, changing family, planning your future, or dealing with land issues.
It's a challenge every day, and you meet an awful lot of nice people.
Your case matters. We'll take the time and the energy to ensure that you have quality experience, quality representation.
Whatever you need, we have a lawyer who can help. Dagger Law. Local. Trusted. Experienced.
Welcome back to Hilliard-Davidson High School as we get set for the second half. Our second half kickoff is being teed up, and it's brought to you by Tiki Bowling Lanes. Fun for the whole family, offering specials throughout the week. To find out more, you can visit them on the web at tikilanes.com. We'll have the first half stats and first half summary report coming right up. But Shu, really, the Hilliard-Davidson Wildcats, after that, after they picked up a turnover from Lancaster on the first drive, their offense has just been clicking. They've, what'd you say, they've had the ball four times and four scores, right?
Yep. They've been flawless, actually. And the only reason they went for 3 points was at the end of the
right.
half. So they've been flawless, Jared. No turnovers, no penalties. You can't get any better than that. Score four out of four possessions.
There you see the halftime score, 24-7. And, boy, the Gales are going to have to come out and find some defense on this first drive as they're going to give the ball to Hilliard-Davidson to start the second half.
Well, you find out what they got to talk about and sort out, and hopefully they can make an adjustment here at halftime in the locker room and come out and perform. But, you know, the combination of quarterback and tailback for Hilliard have been pretty much spelled doom for the
yeah.
Gales.
So as soon as the Gales kick it off, we will get those stats for you. Calvin Sherman to kick it away for Lancaster. It is a high, short kick. Be taken at the 24-yard line. Weimard up across the 25. Tonight's halftime stats brought to you by Don's Furniture, located at 1118 East Main Street. They've been serving Lancaster and Fairfield County area for 23 years. Over those years, Don's has supported numerous charities and youth sports teams, and they continue to support our community. Don's values every customer and wishes all area teams a successful season. To find out more, you can visit them on the web at donsfurniture.com. So as Hilliard-Davidson will get the ball to start the second half, we'll see those stats after this first play.
There's Jared, I formation again. Let's see what happens if they bring that wing back right in to block in that gap. Here he comes. In motion, see it?
Yep, and there's Royer bursting forward for, and there's a flag coming way in. We threw that thing 25 yards.
Hey, they haven't had, he hadn't any practice. Got to warm up, right?
That's true. No penalties in the first half except for the kickoff out of bounds by the Gales.
Yeah, they got the chop
wow.
block. You know, we've talked about that in the past weeks, what that entails.
Here's our call.
He didn't give it, did he?
No, I don't think so. Our Mike the Ref tonight brought to you by Fleet Masters. For over 20 years, Fleet Masters has provided medium and heavy-duty truck repairs for our customers throughout central and southeastern Ohio. They're locally owned and operated with their 10,000-square-foot facility located at 202 Quarry Road in Lancaster. FleetMastersLLC.com. Maybe we'll get a call here shortly. There's a penalty. St. Clair keeps it himself, and he'll be brought down near the 30-yard line.
Yeah, better time accounting for him on the fakes. Like we said, in their option attack, he's not going to give the ball up.
And here's your first half stat shoe.
Well, you give up 260 yards rushing in the first half. They're kind of getting it done to them what they did last week to Newark. So you got to make an adjustment, make a change, and get some stops.
So that's your first half summary report brought to you by Sheridan Funeral Home. I'll tell you about them after this play. Second down and 15 for Hilliard-Davidson. And Royer gets up past the original line of scrimmage. It'll still bring up a third down and about nine. Sheridan Funeral Home is proud to be supporting high school football. They have been serving the communities of Lancaster and Fairfield County for over 100 years, and we thank them for being our first half summary report sponsor. Third down and eight. If the Gales want any chance here in this second half, they desperately need a stop here, trailing 24-7. And they don't have a quick strike offense. It's going to take them some time to put some scores on the board. St. Clair keeps it, and wow, he lost the football, but regained control of it, and he has the first down.
In the option attack, the quarterback makes it go, and he's really good, Jared. Good decision maker. But like I said, his decisions have all been about keeping the football right now.
Yeah.
He did make a late pitch, if you remember, late in the first half, where he had that chance, but he was pitching it to Royer.
Yeah, and it was a good decision, too.
Exactly.
So first and 10, Davidson. Have the ball at their own 46. I formation once again. Sinclair keeps it. This time he stood up right at the line of scrimmage. Initial hit made by Luke Sheridan.
Real nice job by Luke stepping in that time. And again, I just don't know if they accounted for him to be as aggressive as he was in the first half. He got loose. I mean, Royer, you know about. Somebody doesn't come in from rushing over almost 1,500 yards and you don't know about him.
Second and nine for the Wildcats. Sinclair hands it off, first man through. That's Royer. He has a first down and more across the 40 and near the 37-yard line.
Yeah, when they go split backs, he just comes straight down the line and gives him the football right away, and he hits it hard. They really get off the ball really well, yeah. And he comes to the hole fast.
It's offensive line for Hilliard-Davidson doing the job as well tonight, opening up some big holes.
They have really controlled the football game from that point, Jared.
And if you look down there, they're not huge guys, but they've got some speed, and they're just tough. They're just opening up some holes.
Great tradition here, you got to remember.
Here's Royer again, right up the middle, this time tripped up.
It's the same play. Sometimes it's good to give a back-to-back. It's kind of like throwing two changeups on the same at bat. Not bad to do that sometime.
Yep. Spencer Smith made the stop for the Gales. Second down and five. Even on a play that looks like it stopped right away, they get 5 yards.
Well, the key is they're getting off the ball so good. Watch the movement from the offense to the defensive line for the most part on every play.
Sinclair again to Royer. And he has another first down. Every play, 5-6 yards.
That is exactly how Coach White would draw it up if he could. If he were sitting at a grease board with nobody else in there and he drew the plays and what he wanted, this would be it.
Did you just say grease board?
Yes.
Was that Vince Lombardi time frame?
No. Grease board, like, what do you call them, whiteboards? Whiteboard.
We use markers these days.
I know. That's marker what I board. Mean, the grease board with the marker. Yeah, use the razor. Hey, Coach Meyer, I saw a quote in the paper last week. I don't know. I don't remember if I sent that to you where he said.
I don't think so.
They were asking about how he's going to get the offense in line before the Oklahoma game. He said, well, we've been really in the office every morning really early. He said, it's kind of unique. We got a bunch of 50-year-old people staring at grease boards and drinking coffee. He said, kind of weird, isn't it?
Hey, our own Jason Roush was at that game in Oklahoma last weekend. He saw the beat down that the Buckeyes gave the Sooners.
He sure did. The only disappointing thing Jason said that he had is he did not get to ride on the Boomer Sooner because they didn't want to bring it on the field after the rain.
First and 10 after they brought the chains on to measure.
Look at the gaps
confirmed.
In the linemen, how wide they are.
Yeah, they
splits.
Are. Splits. Sinclair again to Royer. Gets up close to the 20.
You know, Coach White and, you know, Marion talked earlier about how to defend the single wing. You got to be so disciplined and you got to, you know your assignments and you can't let them up. I think guarding against Hilliard's the exact same way. You have to have specific assignments. You got to make sure you get to the right spots and fill those gaps. And it's very hard. We've seen them change splits on the offensive line. They use some different formations, but they're always going to run the option.
7 minutes, 30 seconds and counting to play here in this third quarter. And this time, a great job coming in there for the Gales as number 36. That's Chris Sullivan. One of the first times tonight, maybe the first time, that we've seen a tackle
Loss.
Behind the line of scrimmage.
Yeah. Hey, at least they're showing some signs at Lancaster for the Lancaster fans that from their defensive side, showing some signs of getting aggressive and not allowing them just to push you around.
Third and 10 here. For the Wildcats. Clock under 7 minutes to play in this third quarter, and Gales haven't even touched the football in the second half. Sinclair keeps it himself, and he gets up near the 20. It'll bring up a fourth down. And will they bring the kicker on? He made a 37-yarder earlier.
Yeah, you're going to be looking at about a 40-yard field goal.
Yeah, they're going to bring him on.
Well, they've always, like I said, you know, I kind of went through a little bit of that earlier, that they've always had a weapon in their kicking game, and that's something that he kind of tries to plan on. So we'll see. This
it's
is
like a 39-yarder. Was it 37 or 34 earlier he made?
You know what? I don't remember the exact distance it was.
The hole will be put down at the 39. This time it's a low kick, and it will not be made. So I tell you what, the Gales have to be pleased with that – late stop there after they drove it down the field. They did a nice job once it got inside the 30.
Hey, if you're a defensive player, defensive coach, you gotta be happy with that. That's, yep. That's a good effort on that drive. They bent.
First time they've stopped them all night.
And the clock sits at 6 minutes, yep, in the quarter. You gave up 6 minutes is what you gave up. You didn't give up any points, though, so that's a positive.
Yep. So the Gales will take over on downs. First and 10, they'll have the ball at their own 20-yard line.
Sometimes you're getting points in games, and I'm not saying that they can't, but you also get to the point where you can't worry about winning or losing the game. You got to worry about playing better in the game.
It's Bobby Carpenter over on the sideline helping his dad with the Gales. Noah Dryden keeps it. Not much there.
Yeah, he tried a little bootleg and what they call, I believe, a naked bootleg with nobody out there and seeing if he could get loose, but they stayed home defensively.
It's like everybody went to the right except for Noah. He came to the left. We'll give him a pickup of 1, 2nd and 9. Dryden will hand it to Goss. And Goss hit hard at the 21-yard line. No gain on the play.
Strange thing here is they've ran both those plays to the left where they had great success in the first quarter going right.
Gales have passed the football a few times tonight in the first half and didn't look too bad doing it.
No, ran some nice routes, and Noah can throw the football. It's just, you know, pass protection's different.
Yeah.
But it's a part of the game that they need to have in their offensive arsenal.
Strang is split out wide to the right. It's a reverse to Keto Akins. He's following his blocker, trying to get outside. He's got the first down and more across the 35. Still on his feet. Brought down at the 42-yard line. A nice run by Keto Akins. And a nice job by the lead blocker that time, Nick Scott.
Yeah, great job. And when you're in that little inside handoff, sometimes you influence them the other way. And Hilliard's so well coached to go to the ball that they caught him off guard.
Tight end Nick Scott did a good job out there leading the way. And you could see Keto even at one point with his hand on his back. Just following through there. Same play. Akins gets to the outside. He has some room. He's at the 40 and finally brought down at the 36-yard line.
There we go. Back to back. Same thing. I like it.
Why not?
Both teams, we've seen evidence of back-to-back plays here.
So another first down for the Gales. Two plays in a row. Long runs for first downs. Ball spotted at the 36, clock down to 4:10 to play in the third quarter. Gales trail at 24-7. Dryden will reset Scott to the left. Akins goes in motion. Dryden will keep it himself. He was hoping for a block from Akins, but Akins kind of stopped out there on the right side.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was reading in that situation. And I mean the lead blocker. I don't know.
And they will bring him off the field. I don't know if he ran the wrong play or what happened. 2nd down and 9. Dryden gives it to Goss. Goss across the 30 and spins and
got it.
Gets up near the 25 and a first down, I think,
yes,
depending on the spot. Yeah, they're waving him forward.
Yeah, by the mark, get the first down, Jared. Nice play, nice run.
They can put a score on the board here and convert the extra point. You're only down 10.
Yeah, it just takes time to do it. That's the thing, you know. Part of the enemy is going to be the clock at some point.
Yep. You got to get stops, too, which they did that last drive. Here's Barnett going around the right side. Oh, wow, took a hit there late on that run. Gets down to the 22. And Barnett will come out. Akins back in. Clock down under 3 minutes to play in the third quarter. Second down and 7 for Lancaster. Dryden, again, this time it's a reverse and they fumbled. I think Akins was able to fall on it.
He did.
It's a really quick bang, bang type of reverse.
Well, and you're requiring a back to hand it to another back, so that's got to be practiced. And it's an inside handoff.
Still picked up a couple on the play. Make it third down and five.
Timing of that play, which is critical, is Lancaster does an outstanding job on the timing of that play.
Scott resets to the right. Aikens in motion. Dryden keeps it himself. Going around the right side, not going to get the first down. He's across the 20, but going to be shy of the first down. Fourth down and three coming up for Lancaster. Ball spotted at the 19. They need to get to the 16-yard line. Jake Parker resets. There's a handoff to Goss. Goss, I don't know if he got it.
I don't think so.
I don't either. I think he's going to be short by a yard or half a yard. So big stop defensively for Hilliard-Davidson. Let's go down on the sideline. Now Marion Royster has a special guest.
Yes, I'm here with Braden. Thanks, Jared. I'm here with Braden. And Braden, what grade are you in?
Third.
You're in third grade, okay. And I see you got a football jersey on here. Is that the team you play for?
Yes.
What team is that?
Bruins.
The what?
Bruins.
Bruins, okay. Oh, Bruins, okay. All right. And so what do you think of how Davidson's playing out here tonight?
Really good.
Really good, yeah. Well, they're up good, so it looks like they've been playing really well. So do you want to play out here one night under the lights when you get older?
Yes, and I'm going to actually be playing for Davidson.
There you go. All right. I like it. Okay. Well, Braden, thank you so much for being here tonight, and thanks for being such a great fan. And you are Tiberio's fan of the game, so we're going to give you this football here and say thank you so much and congratulations and keep cheering on your Wildcats, okay?
Thank you very much. I can't remember it.
That's okay. Thanks, buddy.
I don't really have a good memory.
That's okay. You did great. Thanks, all right?
Uh-oh, great St. Job. Clair's off to the races. He's not going to be touched.
Yep. 82 yards, Jared.
Wow.
83 yards.
Untouched. The quarterback keeps it himself for an 82-yard touchdown run.
Scoreboard had it marked at the 17. They may
may
call it an 83, but I looked at the yard marker. And
yeah.
But it doesn't matter when it still counts as 6 points.
As soon as we get the extra point, we'll talk to you about Tiberio's Pizzeria and Promotions by Design. Want to thank them. Extra point will be kicked by David Hoyle. It'll be held by David St. Clair, who just ran 83 yards for that touchdown. Kick is up and good. And the Wildcats tack on to their lead, 31-7 now, with 1:31 to play in the third quarter. We want to thank Tiberio's Pizzeria, tonight's Fan of the Game sponsor, providing quality ingredients and exceptional service. Menu items include pizza, pasta, stromboli, and subs. For carryout or delivery, they can be reached at 740-654-2317. We'd also like to thank Catherine Cheek and the gang at Promotions by Design for providing tonight's football that we just gave away to Braden, who plays for the Bruins. And he said it like he's very confident. He's going to be playing out here for Hilliard-Davidson someday.
He seemed very sure, and that's awesome. Great job by Marion with him.
Well, not good news if you're a Gales fan. They trail it 31-7, minute 31 to play in the third quarter. They put together a nice drive last time. It just stalled out there at the end.
Well, when you look at it, you know, not to sugarcoat it or anything, Hilliard scored 5 times in 6 drives, so not a lot to say. That's really the first real big play. But he's just, St. Clair's just, you know, you got to give a lot of kudos to him, though. He has just been tremendous tonight.
It's a short kick. It'll be taken at the 29-yard line by the up man. And getting out to the 35-yard line That was Dalton Stumbo on the return. So the Gales will have it first and 10 at the 35. So Bob's probably going to come in our ears here shortly and say, you get the drive summary is up. That's not really a drive,
is
it?
It's not a drive. That's a big play. I think I'm wearing on them.
They're catching on, aren't they? The only thing we might want to know is how much time. How long did it take him to run 82 yards?
Sometimes it's hard to raise adults. You understand that?
There's Beth.
It's She's the got prettiest the person job. In the truck by far.
Yeah, you're right. Bar none. She has the hardest job of any of us.
Oh, my.
There's Jason. Hey, how was that Buckeye game? Yeah. So timeout on the field. Gales will have it first and 10. A minute 27 to play in the third quarter. And shoot, we have a sponsor we want to thank.
I say thanks to Standing Stone Bank. Whether you're ready to tackle a mortgage, loan, or need cash for home improvements, make Standing Stone Bank the key player in your home or business financial plans. Business to business, neighbor to neighbor, let's grow this town together. Standing Stone Bank, an equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Check this out. We have a shot that Jason took from his phone. Is that the opening kickoff? Check that out. Good seats. Oh, that's national anthem. Look at that on the field.
Flag.
Beautiful. I'm impressed how they coordinate, too, the with their colors in the stands, white, maroon. On first down, Gales carry it up to about the 40, just across the 40. It was Akins on the carry, first down, or being up a second down and five. Shu, we go to these different high school venues each week, and we – we're always amazed at it's not just a high school football game. It's a community event. And
Gilliard-Davidson,
it's no
here.
Different. I mean, they've got some things getting ready to go down on the sideline as we see a run here by Shea Goss for a first down. Going to get another shot. Look where Jason was sitting for that game last week.
Oh, he was whispering plays to Urban Meyer.
He was calling the plays, I think.
Yeah.
Or was he on the Oklahoma side?
No, never.
But he went with an Oklahoma fan. I think he disowned him, though, by the end of the game. First and 10 Gales as they got a first down run by Shea Goss that last play, and now a penalty flag going to come in, and we'll get our Fleet Master's call here.
Dead ball. False start, number 54 of the offense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
There's the officials.
Yes, and that referee is Mike McGrew. Alan Carpenter, Adam Wolf, Ryan Schwederman, and Nathan Lawless is the rest of his crew, which have been very, very quiet tonight.
They haven't had to do much tonight. Well, they've done a lot, but they haven't had to use their whistles and flags much.
Yeah, and had to do a lot of interpretations.
Barnett jumps over top of a defender and gets out to the original line of scrimmage, maybe a yard more than that. And clock's going to roll down. This will probably be the end of the third quarter. I don't think Lancaster's going to run another play. Barnett comes trotting to, he goes trotting to the far side, kind of favoring that left shoulder as he's heading to the left sideline. That's the end of the third quarter. Hilliard-Davidson Wildcats all over the Lancaster Golden Gales. Your score 31-7. We're going to be back for the final 12 minutes of this one coming up next on the High School Football Game of the Week.
I got that real good, feel good stuff. Up under the seat of my big black jacked up truck. Rolling on 35s, pretty girl by my side.
party fouls are pretty dumb. But if you decide to drink and drive underage, you could lose your license and your freedom. Underage drinking and driving. The ultimate party foul.
We open up the fourth quarter with the Gaels facing a third down and 10. Ball spotted just outside of midfield at the 47 and a half yard line. We're right on top of this one, lined up with it. Dryden has DJ Pearson right behind him, and a whistle and a flag coming in.
Dead
a delay
ball.
Of game? Oh, what?
The offense. 5 yard penalty.
A delay of game out of a
third
timeout.
Down.
Don't know about that.
Seemed awfully quick.
Sure did.
You don't typically see a delay of game out of a timeout.
Not usually.
Wow. That makes it a little tougher. Third down and 15 here. High snap, Dryden back to pass. He's pressured, and he's going to be brought down at the 36-yard line. Coming in there for the sack for the Wildcats was number 24, which I don't have on the roster. So the Gaels will be forced to punt. Noah Dryden to kick it away. Jesse Weimar back deep for the Wildcats to receive it. Good high kick.
Real nice punt.
Fair catch called for and taken at the 24-yard line. Tim, at halftime, we were hearing some checking on and hearing some scores from games around the area. Of course, tonight at Fulton Field, it's Fisher Catholic's homecoming, and they were leading Bern Union at the half. It was a 14-6.
Yes.
At halftime of their homecoming game. Fisher started off the year 0-2, but then they got in the win column last, oh, I'm sorry, 0-3, and then got in the win column last week in the game we had at Millersport, a tough, hard-fought game.
It was. The Cardinal Division's really well-balanced, and it's going to be a real battle amongst the seven teams.
First and 10, Wildcats. St. Clair hands it off to the fullback this time. That's Hummel. Not a lot there.
Hey, you got to feed the animal once in a while. He doesn't get very many carries, but you got to give it to him once in a while because he sure does block.
Stop is made by Jaden Jones. Second down and 5. Once again, just 5 yards a carry, and that was with their fullback who hasn't had many carries tonight. Looking down there on the field, it looks like Ryan Royer has his left thigh heavily taped. But he's still in the ball game. He's got some black tape around his white pants. Hand off again right up the middle. And this time, the fullback stopped shy of the first down. Bring up a third and 1. Luke Sheridan on the stop for the Gaels. Called his name a few times tonight defensively. St. Clair with, look at that, power eye formation right behind him. It's to Royer, and I think he's got the first down.
Yeah, that way you don't even have somebody in motion from that slot position. You just got them lined up there. They're blockers anyway. Pretty simple stuff, Jared.
Yep.
But simple doesn't mean it's necessarily run well. You have to coach that and demand that.
First and 10 for the Wildcats. Royer stays back in there, right behind his fullback, Hummel. St. Clair will give it to Royer, and once again gets about 6 or 7 on the carry.
Hey, when you win first down like that all the time, it just makes the night simple.
Yep. Second down and three for Davidson. St. Clair under center, hands it off. And shy of the first down. Clock ticks down to 8 minutes as they do get a first down. They moving the chains? Yes, they are. He got a first down again. So Harry Davidson has had some success offensively tonight. You said it. It's you know what's coming at you. They're going to run the football, but I tell you what, they do an outstanding job. The lead blockers, the linemen open up the holes, and of course that hard running from Ryan Royer and the quarterback St. Clair. Here's Royer coming around the outside, got a good block. He's across the 45 and down out of bounds, close to the 40. That's what it's been all night. That was a 15-yard pickup right there, 14 yards.
Well, in the sense of, you know, the sense of the game, really, it's just a good old-fashioned whipping.
Yeah, you're right.
Jared, they're just whipping them up front. They're running harder. They're blocking them better. They're tackling them better. They're just whipping them tonight. And it's in one game. I understand that. But it's going to show Lancaster what they've got to do to get better to compete in their division starting next week.
First and 10. For the Wildcats. St. Clair hands it off to Hummel. And a pickup of about 4 or 5 on the play. We can tell you for us next week, we're going to be back in the Mid-State League, the Buckeye Division, as the Amanda Clear Creek Aces will be hosting the Fairfield Union Falcons. That's always a big, bitter rivalry game. Fun one to do.
East Fairfield County and West Fairfield County. It's always fun. Yeah, we have a special treat for the sideline reporter next week since Marion cannot make it. So we'll let people hang on.
Yeah, we're not going to give it away yet.
No.
Just tune in. You'll want to get a load of our sideline reporter next week. Third down and 5 for the Wildcats as the clock rolls down to 6:40 and counting here in this ball game.
Can we say we can guarantee you, though, he'll know his stuff?
I think you're right.
Okay.
The big question is, though, will they have a hospitality room for him?
If not, he'll make one.
Third and 5 or 4 for Davidson. St. Clair sends his man in motion. Hands it off to Royer, and this time Royer going to be stopped shy. Oh, well, I spoke too soon. Wow. Looked like he was stopped at the 35 and somehow keeps chugging along and gets up close to the first down.
You know, Jared, that's one of the few times they ran away from formation, and Lancaster had an easier time defending it. It was one less blocker in the Hilliard offense.
Fourth down and 1 for the Wildcats.
There's your power eye again.
St. Clair gives it to Royer, and he was hit at the line of scrimmage, but I think he got enough.
You think?
According to the side judge coming in, I don't know. The one on this side looks like he's short. The one on the far side came in. It's going to be close. They're going to have to bring in the chains and measure.
Now, where they said it, I think they did, but I wasn't sure from the pressure that Lancaster gave. Did a really nice job on that down defensively. That's probably as tough as they played all night right there on the down.
Derek Bowman and Luke Sheridan led the way, and they stopped him.
Good for Lancaster.
Yeah. One of the few times they've been able to stop Ryan Royer tonight. So the Gales will take back over on offense. First and 10, they trail at 31-7 with 5:25 to play in the ball game. And actually, they're going to bring Jaden Jones in to quarterback the rest of this game for the Gales. He actually quarterbacked the entire game in their first win of the season as Noah Dryden was out with an injury. So Jones got that first victory against Cathedral. The junior quarterback. Now a whistle and an official timeout. Equipment problem on that far side for Lancaster. He got to figure it out. Jones hands it off to Shea Goss. He slipped and a knee went down behind the line of scrimmage.
Hey, let's say thanks to Dagger Law. They have more than 110 years of combined expertise in nearly every part of law. With Dagger Law, you're getting a trusted partner in addition to a team who can help you with a growing business, changing family, planning your future, or dealing with land issues. Whatever you need, they have a lawyer who can help. Dagger Law, local, trusted, and experienced.
Jones again hands it off to Shea Goss. Goss fighting his way forward, close to a first down. Let's go down on the sideline to Marion Royster.
Thanks, Jared. I'm here with a few of Hilliard-Davidson's cheerleaders. I'll let them introduce themselves.
I'm Sydney Champion. I'm Reese Ashley.
I'm Katie Shad.
All right, thanks, ladies. And all you guys are seniors, is that correct? Okay, now I have to say, this crowd might be one of the most rowdiest, pumped-up crowds I've ever seen. Is there anything special that you guys do to keep them all riled up throughout the game?
We just keep them pumped up throughout doing all the chants and dances and stuff and spiriting.
That's great. Have they been like this for years, or is this something new?
I think we've always been like this because our student section's a big part of our school, and it's really important to us.
Well, that's great. I love to see it. So you guys, you know, obviously, like I said, you're going to be seniors, so you've done a great job here as, you know, cheerleading, obviously. Do you have any plans for after you graduate?
Yeah, I'm planning on going to college somewhere. I'm not sure yet. I'm looking at places all around Ohio, like UC, some other places, Miami University, so yeah.
I've been looking at Ohio University, OSU, and UC, and a couple out-of-state places, just for fun.
I plan to go to college also. I'm looking at OSU, OU, and UC.
No pressure, but if you want to go to OU, it's a great school. Just thanks. Back to you guys.
All right. Thanks, Marion.
Hey, I wondered how long that was going to take to come out. At some point, he was going to have to express that. He kept
hearing plug in
OU.
There for the Bobcats.
Absolutely.
Speaking of the Bobcats, they didn't look too bad last week against Tennessee, playing an SEC team. And,
no.
Boy, kept it within, 10, 15 points? Lost by 9 points, I'm told. First down run that last time for Shea Goss. It's first and 10 Gales at the 45. Clock down to 3:11 to play in the ballgame. Jaden Jones back to pass. And he's pressured. Lofts one down there. And tender receiver Garrett Strang ran a short route, stopped, and then picked up and went.
Pressured would be an understatement. I think he threw that with two guys hanging
on
him, Jared.
Second and 10 for Lancaster. Coming up, we'll have our players of the game. We'll have one from each team tonight. Stay tuned for that. As the clock has stopped, a rare stoppage of the clock
That's
in this
true.
Game tonight. I mean, we have one turnover and just a couple of flags. It's been a clean game.
Been a physical ball game.
Coming around the near side, that's Brendan Harris on the carry.
The thing I like too is kids make the play, hard hit, whatever. They don't get up and jump up pull in
True,
attention to themselves.
That,
no, they just get up and go to the huddle and play the next play.
Yep.
I love it. You know, when you make $1 million a year, you can do that. Who cares?
I mean, even when St. Clair ran 83 yards for a touchdown, just give the ball to the ref, run to the sideline. Well, actually, for him, he had to go run and hold the ball for the extra point. But opposite side now, carried by A.J. Cook. Cook lowers his shoulder and gets up near the 40-yard line and bring up a fourth down.
They strung that so wide that he just could not get his shoulder square to make a lot of yards, but he did a really good job at the end of making something positive out of that.
A.J. has a lot of speed. That's a kid that played JV baseball for me last year as a center fielder as a freshman, and he's the quickest kid in the Lancaster baseball program as a freshman last year. So he's got a lot of speed. Look for him to do some things on this football field for the Gales coming up in the next few years. Jones back to pass on fourth down, pressured again. Fires one down the middle of the field. No nobody actually, a couple of guys were out there, but again, they stopped their route and it's turned over on downs.
Well, as Don Meredith would say, right? Turn out the lights, yeah. The party's over.
I think you're
all
right.
All good things must come to end.
Well, I think it's about time to announce our players of the game. Shu, which one do you want to do first?
Well, let's do the visitors.
All right, let's do the visitors. Tonight's visiting team, player of the game, brought to you by the Edwards Insurance Agency, specializing in providing personalized insurance coverage that meets the needs of our individual clients. Contact Dale, Todd and Dale Edwards today.
Keto Atkins deserves player of the game. The 5'11 senior carried the ball in those inside handoffs, really battled for yards, and had a nice overall game. Very consistent throughout, Jared.
Number 7 for the Gales. Congratulations, Keto, on being our Edwards Insurance Agency player of the game. Our home team player of the game brought to you by Fairfield National Bank. At Fairfield National Bank, we believe a strong community is built with local volunteers, donations, and leadership. Last year, Fairfield National Bankers supported 183 local organizations like youth clubs, social services, animal protection groups, schools, health organizations, nature centers, and more. It's an honor to be a part of the good things happening every day in towns where we live and work. Fairfield National Bank invites you to join us this year and find new ways to support your community too. Fairfield National Bank is a division of Park National Bank, member FDIC.
Well, Jared, is there any doubt? I mean, David St. Clair was a game changer tonight. He controlled the game totally from the second quarter on. Hilliard's offensive line was outstanding. Their defense has been really, really good tonight. But David St. Clair made the difference tonight. 6 foot senior quarterback just was outstanding. I can't say enough positive things about him. No turnovers, handling the ball in the triple threat option, and making great decisions. What a game for David St. Clair.
I agree. Third down and 3. New quarterback has been in the ball game for the Davidson Wildcats, and here's a first down run for a new running back into the ball game.
Looks like a young Johnny Unitas, doesn't it? Number 19 out there.
That's true.
I know I'm dating myself a little bit here, but
hey, while we get down under a minute to play, Marion won't be with us next week, and special reasons why, right, Mario? We want to wish you the best of luck, you and your wife, as you're going to be adding someone to the Royster family.
Thank you very much, Jared. Yes, we're very excited. Going to be inviting a new baby girl into our family. My wife is due here in a couple weeks, so looking forward to that and preparing for it. And it's a beautiful thing, and we're excited. So thanks so much.
Can't wait to see pictures, Marion, and I'm sure that we'll welcome her, and all of Fairfield County and our IVP family will welcome her when she's born. So congratulations early, because we won't get to talk to you until she's born, but congratulations and good luck to you and your wife.
Thank you so much.
Well, the clock's going to tick down here on the Lancaster Golden Gales as they come to Hilliard-Davidson, and the Wildcats put a thumping on them, 31-7. So congratulations to the Hilliard-Davidson Wildcats. After they lost 2 games in a row, they come back with a vengeance tonight.
Looked like a well-oiled machine tonight, and got focused and got their mind on what they should be doing. Didn't make any mistakes, and just got to give credit where credit is due, Jared. And you know, they're ready for jumping their league and their division, and Lancaster's now got to regroup tonight and get ready. Is it Grove City next week, I believe?
Yeah.
So doesn't get easier, but you got to get better, and that's what you got to do. And the one thing is, Lancaster will have something to look at on film to really measure, really just areas of effort and focus and decision making.
Right. Tonight's final stats are brought to you by Don's Furniture and Mattress, located at 1118 East Main Street. They've been serving Lancaster and the Fairfield County area for 23 years. Over those years, Don's has supported numerous charities and youth sports teams, and they continue to support our community. Don's values every customer and wishes all area teams a successful season. To find out more, you can visit them on the web at donsfurniture.com.
Well, Lancaster rushed the ball really well tonight for 223 yards, but when you give up 386 yards rushing, and I bet the time of possession was huge, Jared, because Hilliard's drives, even though some of them weren't real lengthy, they did just a good job of controlling the ball and just totally outplayed Lancaster tonight, totally, from all facets of the game.
They sure did, and Lancaster looked like they were going to start off strong. They had a nice long drive, and then it ended with the turnover, and from there it was just all Davidson.
They came back and tied it, made a beautiful drive, Gales did. And actually, they moved the ball for the most part of the night, but just didn't finish a few drives.
Well, coming up next week, we'll have an in-county rivalry. You said it, West Fairfield County against East Fairfield County, as the Amanda Clear Creek Aces will host the Fairfield Union Falcons, and that's going to be an exciting game. Shu, what are your thoughts on that one?
It's hard to tell, really, because I think we're just starting to get a feel for that Buckeye division, you know, and we have not had the opportunity to see Amanda yet. We had a chance to see Fairfield Union. They've made improvements.
Yeah.
They had a really tough loss in the first league game last week. See how they bounce back this week. Amanda's trying to regroup also. They struggled out of the gate, picked up a win, and then again lost a tough ball game last week. So, but we've done that Amanda Fairfield Union game for years. It is always interesting and a little bit of a slugfest between the two.
Well, again, Marion, your final thoughts on tonight's game. And, again, we wish you the best of luck. We won't be with you next week, but you'll be in a good place.
Yeah.
You got a good excuse.
Yes, yeah, I hope so. Hopefully, Bob won't hold this one against me. But looking forward to getting back with you guys. But, I thought we had a great game tonight. You know, Lancaster, I didn't think, played that bad. Just Hilliard really just played as close to a perfect game as they could. You know, no turnovers. Really ran their offense flawlessly. Didn't give up any big plays on defense. And, that was the tail of the tape at the end of the game.
All right. Thanks again, Marion. We'll see you in a few weeks. Good luck to you and your wife.
Thanks, guys. Take care.
I want to thank all our crew, Jim Spires, Kirby Woolover, Tom Russo, our cameraman, in the truck, Aaron Ull, Bob Competti, Jason Roush, and Beth Competti. Tim, another fine game tonight for us, and going to be a good one next week.
Hey, it's always fun, Jared. Appreciate getting our weekend, off on the good foot right here.
Once again, your final score, Hilliard-Davidson 31, Lancaster 7, 4. Marion Royster and Tim Shoemaker. I'm Jared Stewart. Have yourselves a great night, everybody.
IVP Sports presents the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Football Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, Ohio University Lancaster, Fairfield DD, The Huddle Tire Company, Personal Touch Party Rentals, Tiki Bowling Lanes, The Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, North Body Shop, Fairfield Federal, Don's Furniture, Sheridan Funeral Home, Fairfield National Bank, the Edwards Insurance Agency, Kumler Collision and Automotive, the Carriage Company, Adam H., Dagger Law, Infinitely Outdoors, the Lancaster Eagle Gazette, Standing Stone Bank, Buckeye Lake Marina, Tiberio's Restaurante, and Fleetmasters. This has been an IVP Sports production.